Hello viewers, today we have with us Dr. Jayalakshmi TK, consultant pulmonologist at Apollo Hospitals, Navi Mumbai. Today we'll be discussing on COVID-19 and pneumonia. Welcome to our Facebook live session, doctor.
Thank you.
The first question is, what is pneumonia? Can you explain? And how COVID-19 virus causes pneumonia?
So pneumonia is any infection affecting the air spaces in the lung. This can cause an opacification in the lung, which can be seen like a patch on the chest X-ray or the CT scan. It usually associated with some signs of blood infection as well, and associated with fever, cough, expectoration or sputum production, maybe even blood or rusty sputum, and breathlessness.
How is it different from common or normal pneumonia?
So typically, if we find that in pneumonia there is chest pain, lung involvement is usually only on one side, because it is unilateral involvement, and also associated with expectoration and fever. But in COVID-19 pneumonia, usually there may not be much of sputum coming out, and there may not be so much classical chest pain, and usually the symptoms of breathlessness and dry cough along with the other symptoms of COVID like fever, headache, body ache are seen.
What are the symptoms of COVID-19 pneumonia?
Usually in COVID-19 pneumonia, patient presents with breathlessness first. So patient may have a low oxygen saturation. Normal oxygen saturation is 98 to 100%. So these patients will have a slow falling of the saturation, 97. Then it may fall even to below 90, and they feel breathless when they are talking or walking or climbing stairs. So all these routine activities can give breathlessness. So breathlessness is the main, can be also associated with dry cough and the other symptoms of COVID like fever, body pain, headache, fatigue.
How is COVID-19 pneumonia diagnosed?
So the COVID-19 pneumonia is diagnosed first by a history in which the patient complains of breathlessness and dry cough in addition to the symptoms of COVID. And also the test at the pulse oximetry, which shows the oxygen saturation to be falling. A chest X-ray, which shows bilateral, that is on both sides, and a diffuse, that is generalized shadows, which are ill-defined, not very clearly defined like the usual pneumonia. And a CT scan picture, which shows bilateral, that is on both sides, small patches, which is more in the subpleural, that is the side areas of the lung. So this is a very classical picture which is seen, and CT scan also is shown to be very sensitive in picking up even very mild cases of COVID.
What needs to be done once these symptoms of COVID-19 pneumonia are seen in a patient?
So once there is a pneumonia or lung involvement with COVID, it is better to admit the patients. And if the saturation is less than 95% on room air, then the patient is administered supplemental oxygen. Also, the medications are started by which the tests are done first to see how serious the involvement is. The X-ray is done, CT scan is done if required, and blood tests are done to see the seriousness of the COVID infection, and accordingly the patient is started on medications.
So, doctor, how many people with COVID-19 will get pneumonia?
It is difficult to say, because all patients with COVID-19 are not really tested with the X-ray or saturation or CT scan. But when CT scans are done in COVID-19 patients, surprisingly large number have been found to have lung involvement. Up to 80% to 90% of patients are seen to have some level of pneumonia, at least in the studies which have been done.
Who are the most vulnerable to get COVID-19 pneumonia during this time?
So during this time, actually anybody who has COVID is vulnerable to get the pneumonia. But having said that, patients with pre-existing lung diseases like asthmatics or COPD patients or old TB patients or patients with existing damaged lung, they are more likely to get a more severe type of pneumonia. And for patients with more severe respiratory failure or severe breathing difficulty, they may benefit in addition to oxygen, by means of high flow nasal cannula giving a very higher concentration of oxygen, or a machine called as a BiPAP, which is like a non-invasive ventilator where there is no tube put, but at the same time you can give supplemental oxygen. and help with the breathing, and also some patients may require intubation and mechanical ventilation using a ventilator.
Are there treatments for COVID-19 pneumonia?
So currently the treatment has improved over the last few months for COVID-19 pneumonia, and patients are doing well with steroid treatment. Different types of steroid, dexamethasone, methylprednisolone have been used. Also, some patients benefit with the antiviral drugs, that is remdesivir and the newer favipiravir which has come. And some patients are benefiting with other medications like tocilizumab and other immunomodulatory treatments.
We come to the last question. How can we prevent COVID-19 pneumonia?
So the basic way to prevent COVID-19 pneumonia is only to avoid getting the COVID itself. So I would urge all my viewers to continue, even in this unlockdown period, to continue the social distancing, wearing masks, washing hands, and be as careful as they've been in the last first 3 months, and to continue this till the epidemic has passed.
Thank you, Doctor, for joining this session. Dear viewers, if you have any question related to this topic, please drop your questions in the comment box and we'll address it to Dr. Jayalakshmi.
Thank you so much for having me. Thank you.